Welcome back to How to BIM. In this new tutorial, we're going to create a Dynamo script that will help us automatically add dimensions to our model elements. So let's get started. So the first thing to do is launching Revit. This is the model we're going to need for today's tutorial. I made sure to add the download link in the description below so you can guys save the model and follow through with me step by step in this tutorial. So make sure that you open a floor plan before launching Dynamo. We're going to go to Manage, Dynamo, and we will create a new file. So if this is your first time using Dynamo, you could either get your notes from the library. Scrolling down, I'm going to use the Revit package, selection. Scroll down until you find select model elements by category. This is one way to do it. The other way is by right clicking and typing the name of the node. Let's choose the node. Now we have to choose the category of the elements we're going to select. Let's scroll down till we find walls. And then click on select. At this point, you should be able to see your floor plan, so you could select your elements in Revit. And then click on finish. The next node we're gonna need is a dimensions by element. If you're interested in more Dynamo tutorials that will help you automate your modeling process, you can check the playlist in the right top of the screen. I have multiple videos that can help you save a lot of time. And then we're gonna type current to get the document.current node. And then we're going to type active view and get the document.active view node. Now we'll just link the output of document.current with the input of document.activeView and then the output with the input in document by elements, and then simply take the output of the selection node and link it with the reference elements in the dimensions by elements node. This is a very simple process. Next, we will right click and type element dot get location, and then we will link its input with the output of the selection node. The next node we're gonna need is a curve dot point at parameter, and we will link the geometry with the curve. Let's just put these in here. Now the next node would be a simple number slider. You can set the minimum and the maximum depending on how much you want your dimensions to slide up and down a certain range. Let's do a little trial. So right now you could only see the points moving because we didn't add a line. Slide this one here and right click to get best fit through a point. Line dot best fit through point node. And then we will link its output, which is the line, with the line in the dimension by elements node. And now once we check our Revit model, we can view how our dimensions appeared. So I assume you guys noticed that the dimensions we have created only work when they're all in the same direction. So we need to create dimensions for the other directions or the walls in the other direction. So let's create a group and then give it a name. Walls dimensions. This is the X. And then let's click and press on control and slide our group down and create a new group for the vertical walls. We're going to do the same process we did earlier during the selection of the walls. So let's just click on change and then choose the category, which is walls again. Now select the walls we want to add dimensions to. I think that's good. And now I click on finish. And we automatically had our dimensions added, obviously with the same parameters as you as earlier, but it changed the parameters and the range or and anything we want to personalize. And yes, that's it. That's the whole tutorial. It's short and easy, but it's so effective and it will save you a lot of time. So make sure you save your script once you try it and share it with your friends and colleagues. I'm sure they'll be so grateful. Yes, thank you for watching. If you like my content, make sure to click on the like button. That way YouTube will recommend more videos like that to you. And if you're interested in my tutorial specifically, you can check my channel for more playlists like that, whether it's for Dynamo, Navisworks, or Revit. And yes, thank you again for watching.